Hello everyone, this is our second interview of the day. We're here with Canadian Finance Minister Bill Morneau. So we've left some inside information on how the G7 summit works. So Prime Minister Trudeau has said that he's looking to create some sort of like a contribution from the G7 countries towards girls' education. But how do you negotiate with other nations to ensure that you're meeting those goals?
This is always the challenge around a table where there's seven economies.
Yeah.
The good news though on this front is that there's a sense of the importance of this issue really among the G7 countries. So we all recognize that the success of our countries, of our economies, and the success of the world has a huge amount to do with doing better for realizing the opportunity for girls in America. So that's a great starting point. So what Prime Minister Trudeau wants to do is to actually have some tangible ways that we can actually make change happen. So that's really his goal. You start with a good base, you get agreement among your partners, and you try and push people carefully, but in a positive way, to real change. That's what we're trying to achieve.
And so the Education Commission recommends that countries or donor nations dedicate 15% of their foreign aid towards education, but Canada's only Canadians only dedicate 7%. So why is that, and how can the country do more?
We always want to do more in everything that we're trying to achieve internationally, and education is not different. So we're going to make a statement, prove what we're doing in that regard, and we need to do that in the context of the other countries. Have commitments around the world to both deal with, say, for instance, refugee issues, for real challenges that we see in part of the world that find them in a very impoverished situation. So we always need to balance, but what we're going to see over the course of the next couple of weeks, and importantly at the G7 Leaders Conference, is a real focus on girls' education, focus on how we can empower young people to be more successful. And that I think, is pretty exciting.
Yeah, for sure. And so Malala Fund supporters want to see progress in girls' education during this G7 summit, but we also know that in order to do that, we need to go beyond the G7 summit next week. So we need to ensure that our countries are continuing to support this cause. So what are your plans for ensuring that girls' education stays on the global agenda beyond the G7 summit?
Well, let me just speak personally for a second.
Yeah.
I've been on this cause for a while. I actually founded a school for refugee girls in Kakuma Refugee Camp in Kenya. It's called the Watershed Palace Center for Secondary School for Girls. So this has been a passion of mine for many years. I think what you're seeing from Prime Minister Trudeau, what you'll certainly see from me, is a continued focus in this area at these sort of meetings, but more broadly. So we'll be out talking about it. We'll be bringing it back to the table so that we can keep focus on something that we know is foundational for our long-term success. It's an exciting time to be doing this, and it's really important to take the leadership opportunity that we have with the G7 leadership to make a difference. That's what we're going to do.
All right, so thank you so much for joining us, and stay tuned for updates.
Okay, thanks very much.